Hello everyone, my name is Brian and welcome to another Smite commentary. And for today we will be playing a warrior. Yes, it has been a while. I don't play warriors that often though. It's not really an excuse that it will go bad. I just don't play them that often. A couple of them I really like. Hercules is one of them. Guan Yu is probably my favorite one. I really like to play Guan Yu. I like Chuck, Bologna. A couple of warriors I almost never play, like Ravana, Osiris. Those type of gods I usually don't play. Not sure what it is. I think that if I play a warrior, I would like to play a ability based one. Like for instance, if you look at Tyr, Tyr is also one of those gods that is more ability based. And I do like those a lot more than the basic attack oriented warriors. Bologna being a little bit of an exception. You can kind of build her whatever you want, since she has the damage with her abilities, but she also has the... I missed everyone. She also has the choice or the opportunity to go for the basics for a basic attack oriented build. Looks like I will be stunned. I can grab someone, or at least try to. My 2 is back off of cooldown. Let's see if we can get someone. I mean, if I do it correctly, I can push someone into the Artemis trap, which is, to be honest, is pretty difficult to really get going. It's definitely something I would like to try though. If I managed to pull that off, it would actually be... Ah, that's fortunate. That would have been very, very good. Looks like he's going to commit. Oh. Actually, I didn't get pulled, so I guess I was at the right portion of it. Sunder used there, so I'll need to be a little bit careful. Never mind. Oh, he was stunned for such a short duration. What? Does he have the boots? That's actually an option, or I always forget the name. Oh, you're so dead. Maybe not. Yeah. Ooh, that blink. I don't know why the Neath has blink, but that was a hot blink, not gonna lie. Able to avoid the Amaterasu ultimate as well as survive. I didn't know if the mirror was up from the Amaterasu. That would have been a better option. I guess not, because, well, otherwise she probably would have used that instead of the ultimate. But yeah, that was a very good blink. I don't know why Neath has blink though. It's really odd to me. I feel like, especially against this team... Oh, that silence was very good by the enemy on Amaterasu. She dashed into me, which silenced me, and I wasn't able to push the honor when I wanted to. Otherwise, honor would have died, guaranteed. I can't believe I missed that. Let's pull him up. Looks like the damage isn't enough. Also, that pull is into a pillar. I mean, they will be knocked up, but they will be stuck onto that portion of wall. It can be against every wall, for instance, well, actually every wall, I can pluck someone at the other side of a wall if I hit him, but they will just be stuck behind that wall, so that is an option. Not sure what I want to level though. Let's pop my 3 for a little bit of regen. I think I was in time. I wasn't, because I didn't get any additional healing. It's unfortunate, but I do get some healing from just straight up tapping the button. And I did put another point into it. Just smack her a little bit. And make sure that I push her away before she fires that mirror, so I don't take damage at all. Looks like Chen Chen goes for the ultimate. Isn't able to pick up anything except for a couple of minions. So we should be fine. I'm kind of looking for someone else though. I mean, he's quite tanky. He's looking for Neath. Doesn't really have anything though. I do have my ultimate. I am hit by the one from Chen Chen, so that does reduce my damage by a good amount. Come on. I don't have the mana. Didn't have enough mana for the push ult combo. Probably would have killed... Well, I definitely think it would have killed him, unless of course he's able to dodge it, but yeah, I guess it's fine. By the way, if you're wondering why I went for Wingblade, I feel like that's actually a very good item for Hercules, because he relies on his movement speed a lot to get close to his opponents. And they do have a couple of slows. Let's use Shell to help out the Artemis. Artemis goes for the ultimate. Will buy some time. I think that Shell definitely helps out as well. It's not a huge amount, especially rank 1. Oh my god, that's a double. That was a terrible ult. I am so good at this game. Oh, that's kind of annoying. I had to move back to hit them properly. And because of that, they had enough time to both dodge. They both went the right way, not gonna lie. One went to the left, the other to the right. Were able to dodge both of them. Well, they both were able to dodge it. Bit unfortunate, otherwise I think one would have died. Or at least one. Let's see, we do have the buff. Let's push her into the wall. Body block if we can. And that's going to be a kill. Let's just provide some pressure for my team. I don't want them to be killed. I don't have any mana though. But I can use my... Come on. Yeah, I reached. Nice. Fortunately enough, does cost Artemis a life. The fact that I chased and able to hit that one over the wall or through the wall or whatever you want to call it. Maybe I should have stayed with the Artemis. I think I could have saved her. But I was greedy. Okay, not gonna lie. I don't really play to be a support. You know my playstyle. I like to carry. I like to go in, go ham, go all the way. And I knew I could get it. So that's also one of the things that was like, kind of wanted to just go for it. Looks like the honor is a bit distracted. Not enough though. He does move backwards for no particular reason otherwise than just moving. I don't know. Sometimes I feel like it's more difficult to hit someone that is actually paying no attention whatsoever than someone that's paying no attention. That's kind of annoying. Looks like he will fall. Can we get the Gebrecken as well? Ultimate. He is quite tanky though. Looks like the minions are going through the portal, but the Poseidon is going for it. So we can definitely defend. Some minions got through though, but not all of them. So I guess we're fine. Actually a lot of damage by them. Should be fine though. My team is around, so I can go a little bit more aggressive. And I did pop my 3, so... Nice. Good damage. Let's get the Shield of Regrowth. It's one of my favorite items on Hercules, and if you haven't tried it out... What have you done? Were you living under a rock? No, you definitely need to try it out. It is so unbelievably dumb on Hercules. You can just pop your 3, get additional movement speed. And because I have Wingblade as well... Nice. In the trap, even. Uses the ultimate, gets the Neath. Okay, that's a little bit awkward. And he gets out as well. Nobody did any damage to that honor. That kind of sucks. I guess we can go for the Amaterasu. Dealing a good amount of damage. And Poseidon is able to finish it off. But yeah, the shield regrowth. Every time you use a heal. By an ability, I think. Life still doesn't count. But you... Come on. Wasn't able to get it through. A little bit too aggressive, I think. Oh, I'm so dead. That's unfortunate. Without the Gebrecken ultimate, I think I might have lived there. Because I have so much additional movement speed. And the enemy soul actually hit her with my 2. Or hit me with her 2. Which slows, or is supposed to slow, which triggered my wing blade. So, if that Gebrecken wall wasn't there, I actually would have lived. Which is not bad. Looks like he used purification. It sounded like he used purification as well. So, that's both relics on the honor. I definitely think it was the case. Or that was the case. Let's pull the soul. And she will fall down before she gets into her... invulnerability, and looks like... Oh, he misses Sunder as well. Sunder used by the Chinchen misses the Artemis, and she will live, and he will die. So far, it's going very well. We're 17 and 8. So, dang it. That Amaterasu is on point with her silences. Actually, very, very good. Using my ultimate there for CC immunity, trying to dodge out the spears from the honor. Using my 3 for additional movement speed, getting altered by the Gebrecken. Stunned in between, or when I tried to go for the touching the shield just barely. And I live with almost no HP. That was very, very lucky. They used a lot on me and they weren't able to pick me up because of the additional movement speed I gained from my 3. Amaterasu was very close though. She missed her 2 because I sidestepped when I heard her dash in. And I was able to dodge that one, so... I can't say baited, but it was just straight up luck. But also a little bit of awareness. I mean, I heard the Amaterasu dash, so I was able to respond with that by going sideways, and was able to dodge an ability with that. That definitely would have killed me because I had like 50 HP. Let's see if we can provide some peel. Ah, oh, that's unfortunate. The Kabrekan. Tremors was close enough to the knee. Oh, seriously, Jinchan, you're going to lag out of my ability. He definitely lagged out of my ability there. Kind of sucks, but it's okay. He still dies. And we might be able to pick up the Amaterasu as well. Let's go for the additional movement speed. Pull her in. Push her out. Oh, never mind. Artemis has the kill. That's fine, though. That pull definitely makes it a lot easier. Otherwise, I need to otherwise, I should have used or could have used my one to push into her. But it would not have been enough damage. Nice stun by the Kabrekan. I wanted to push him towards my team. Not going for that anymore. Sol is my next target. And not hitting. What is... How? Why is Jinchen so far at our base and killed Artemis? What? Okay, I am a bit confused. What? Two questions. Why was Jinchen there and why did Artemis die to the Jinchen on her own next to the base? I don't know. I didn't see what happened, but it's not something you'll see every day. Nice. This time I forced out the purification beads. Amaterasu used her dash already when I was pulling him, but not on me, so that was definitely nice. Used my sheller. I don't know if it was a good No, it was definitely a very bad shell. That's my bad. I expected them to commit a little bit harder. Let's see if we can go for it. Oh, are you kidding me? Ah, okay. At least he falls. I was like, are you kidding me? Ana gets away with like 0 HP. But we will be able to pick up the Kabrekan as well. 6-1 and 15 is going very well, actually. Able to hit my 2-1 a bit more than in the beginning. I missed a lot at the beginning, which kind of sucks. I also picked up the breastplate to get full cooldown reduction. I don't have a lot of power, but as Hercules, you don't really need it that much. I have power into my boots, and that's literally all the power I have. But I will still smack the opponents for a good amount of damage. And my ability still hurt because the base damage is just pretty high since I'm a warrior. Let's just push him away. Allow my team to have some more room. And then I'll rotate and to help them out. Kraken a little bit off the mark. Let's see if we can push away the Jinchen so we can provide some peeling for the Neath. Go away, Jinchen. Leave my Neath alone. And he will fall down. That's body blocker. Aw. She used her ultimate. Actually, very good ultimate. Don't think she had a choice. Oh, nice damage by the Kronos. And we'll just shred through that Amaterasu. Ooh, that damage. Let's see if we can provide some peel. Sprint for the Kronos. I'm trying to body block. I can't body block that. I'm sorry. I tried, okay? I tried. Let's at least prevent the Jinchen from providing that root onto our Artemis. And ult to... Not get ulted by the Jinchen, but it actually finishes him off, which is probably better. But I mainly use it for the CC immunity. And to try and hit the others as well, but it was actually enough to finish off Jinchen, so I was completely fine there. Picked up the Bulwark. With the Bulwark and the Wingblade, I have 40% CC reduction. So that means that if I get stunned, the duration is reduced by a lot. Looks like I will be able to pick up Ana. He will be... Oh, that is... Very unfortunate. I should have moved back a little bit more to make sure that I hit him before he was able to get out of the whirlpool. Because the whirlpool prevented him from leaping, so I knew he was trying to go for that. But yeah, it wasn't happening. Nice root by the Neath. And a nice fancy backflip to finish that off. Definitely a stylish way to finish. Come on. Nice. Again, purification beats forced. Can the boulder hit him? Yes, he... Juked the wrong side. If he went to the right side, he would have been able to dodge it, but he didn't. So, nice. To be fair, if you're in that situation as the honor, you kind of have to gamble, because if you look around to see where it's coming from, you'll be too late. Looks like Kabrekan goes for the Neath. That's pretty rude. I just pulled him, didn't push him, because I felt like... That's also something that you need to be careful for. If you pick up something, someone like Jinchen or the Kabrekan in this case, and you literally push it towards a teammate's feat, like for instance Poseidon, Artemis, or whatever, actually every single one of my teammates, that means that the Kraken gets a free engagement onto them, because my damage isn't that much. The CC won't do too much because it's a Guardian, and that will just straight up make it a lot more difficult. Ana used his escape already. CC immunity. I need to get out. I do have my 3 up in a bit, so I will get the additional movement speed. I don't get movement slow immunity, but looks like they... Oh, they're chasing me so much. Shell for my team, but also for me. Pull the Kraken away from the Artemis. Provide some time, and it will be enough for the Kronos to pick up the Kraken. Let's just hard engage, see if we can help out the Neath. Gets the blink off. Wasn't in combat for a long time. Let's see if we can dodge more. I'm playing a little bit too aggressive, but it looks like the amount of movement speed I have, they just cannot keep up with me. There's just no way they will be able to keep up with me because of that increased movement speed shield of regrowth and the increased movement speed when they try to slow me down. It's just too much for them to deal with. And also have, well, at the moment, 3200 HP, which is also not something you burst through quickly. Looks like Kraken thought otherwise. I'm not going to let you hit me like that. I'll just go aggressive, push him, and let's see if we can get honor. Never mind. He's scared, and with a good reason. Soul used her ultimate. I think she used Purification Beast as well, if I wasn't mistaken. I do have the Frostbind now. Should make it easier to hit, but I'm still missing everything. Let's just use the ult. Ah, she has Sanctuary. Come here. Come here, you little soul. You're going to lose. You can't get away from this one. And she will fall down. That's going to be an ultimate by the Jin Chan. Not sure what they're going to do. I mean, how much damage can you do? To be fair, Ana was there, but still. I'm a Hercules. Oh, I pushed him out of the crack. My bad. I am the best. But that will be it. And that's going to be a very... Well, it was a pretty one-sided match, not gonna lie. But it's not like they had a bad composition. And we didn't even have that much of a front line, which maybe was the reason why it went so well. But all of my teammates were ranged. 3 of them were basic attack oriented. You have the Kronos, you have the Neath and the Artemis. All rely on basic slot. Actually, Poseidon can rely on basic slot as well. Let's see if they picked up anything to kind of counter that, because that is something that you want to look for. If you see a team like mine, basic attack speed or just attack speed reduction is key against all these gods. Artemis doesn't do as well if she has less attacks in a certain amount of time. Same for Kronos, especially with the build he went for. Because Kronos can be viable with attack speed, but usually I honestly don't like it as much. I usually build just a lot of power and then at the end build a Hastened Vitalis just for funsies. And you'll just shred through everything. But Poseidon can do a lot of damage as well. He also has the Hastened Vitalis, which I like a lot. But yeah, it's just every single one of our teammates was relying on the basic a lot. Probably Neath the least, or me. That's actually not true. I relied on my basic attacks a lot as well once my cooldowns were... Or once my abilities were on cooldown. But the Neath has a full damage build. No attack speed in any of her items. So she relied on her abilities the most. But yeah, let's just take a quick look. From what I see here, they only have one kind of counter to this. Because we all rely on our basic attacks a lot. Getting Heart of the Nemean on Amaterasu will allow you to reflect a little bit of that damage. But it didn't really work out for her. And I feel like there are a couple of reasons for that. She went for... She has the same health items as I did. But yeah, she went for low protections. And on the Amaterasu, it's not too bad. But our Magicals did a lot of damage. Our Poseidon and the Kronos did a lot of work in this game. And I feel like the enemy soul didn't do as much. And two Guardians, they can only do a limited amount of damage. Wow, Jin Chan died 18 times. Wow, that's actually a lot. He also didn't have any physical protection, which probably is the reason why. Against an Artemis, Neath, and a Hercules, you definitely want to get some physical protection. A breastplate will help you out a lot more than an Ethereal Staff. Especially, well, Ethereal Staff is not bad. But a breastplate against 3 physicals that can do a lot of damage. At least some physical protection would have been nice. Amaterasu didn't get any magical protection. Xin Chen didn't get any physical protection, and I both recommend them for both sides because we just had a lot of damage. That is what our team was, just a lot of damage. Our frontline was literally me and a couple of CCs the others could throw out. So as long as you're able to survive, I feel like they can just do a lot more work than we can, just because they have more of a frontline. I only have two CC abilities into my 2 and my 1, or, well, my ultimate as well, because it has a little knockup component to it. But that's about it. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this one. If you have a request, please let me know down in the comments. I think I have one more request left. I haven't really gotten to that one yet. It is in Conquest, so yeah, that kind of figures. But that was, if I'm not mistaken, Zeus mid. So that's the only request I've left. If you have a request, please let me know. Can be any god. I mean, there are a lot of gods I haven't played for a while. Maybe I should just request things for myself. Just gods I haven't played in forever. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, good luck, have fun, and I'll see you guys in the next one.